So you got that big gig, or your band decided to upgrade from a van to a tour bus. It's your first time on a tour bus. Here's what you need to know. First off, bus etiquette. Whether you're on the bus for a weekend or for 3 months, you're sharing it with a bunch of people who are all calling it home for that time. So you really need to take their feelings and wanting to sleep or not sleep or party into consideration. If you want to party at 3 o'clock in the morning, that's fine. But some people are trying to sleep. So if you need to go get something from the bunk, or if you want to go from one lounge to the next lounge, whatever it is, make sure you close your doors behind you. Just be cool. Clean up after yourself. Whether it's some beers you're having or some kind of other drink, or just hanging and there's a bunch of food on the table, when you're done with it, clean up after yourself. No one wants to wake up at 10 o'clock in the morning and walk out to that. Same goes with the fridge. It's a small fridge shared by a lot of people. So whatever you're putting in there, if it's been a day or two and you're not gonna eat it, toss it. Again, just be considerate. It's not that hard. Another thing that's really important to know about a bus, I mean really important, is it's number one only in the restroom. So, no number two. Everyone brings guests on the bus. It is your job to let your guests know number one only. Super, super important. As far as temperature on a bus, it's usually gonna be absolutely freezing. So make sure that you bring some layers. One of the rules that's worth mentioning is always sleep with your legs forward towards the front of the bus. In case the bus has to stop really fast, really hard, you don't want to have your neck hitting something while you're sleeping. So whether you're in your bunk or you're sleeping in the front lounge on the couch or something like that, make sure that your legs are forward. As far as storage goes on the bus, the bottom of the bus is usually for big luggage and gear. If you have more gear than can fit in there, you throw it in the trailer that's attached to the bus. As for the day-to-day needs, whatever you need on the bus with you while you're driving for 8 hours, in my case, that would be like toothpaste and a toothbrush. I need to take my lenses out, so my glasses, you know, stuff like that. Maybe, like I said, it's gonna be cold, get another layer of clothing. All that stuff goes into the junk bunk. What's a junk bunk? A junk bunk is basically where you put all your junk. So when I'm in the Smash Mouth bus, there's guitars up there, there's skateboards, everyone's packs, there's all kinds of weird shit. That's why it's called the junk bunk. The three main compartments of the bus are the front lounge, the bunk bay, and the back lounge. Front lounge has your couches, it has your TVs, it's got your fridge, it's got your little kitchen area, it's got a restroom. That's about it. The bunk bay is where everyone sleeps. What you're gonna find when you walk into a bunk bay is there's gonna usually be 12 bunks. Three here, three here, then you walk back a little, you have three more, and three more. Altogether, 12 bunks. Good math. If you've got the space, sometimes you can have what's called condos in your bunk bay. So remember how I said there were three on each side and then three later? If you take from the top of the bus to the bottom of the bus, and instead of three, you put two in, each one of those would be called a condo. You can see it right here. What that basically means is you just have more room in your bunk to sit, to play on your computer, whatever it is you want to do. At this point in time, I haven't had that pleasure yet, but one day. When you're touring around, you usually have a green room. With the green room comes the green room rider. What's a green room rider? Well, it's a list of everything we want in the green room. So you could have ice, beers, I don't drink, gum, fruit plates, nuts, whatever you want, put it on the rider. Well, there's also what's called a bus rider. So every day you get stuff brought to the bus, whether it's ice or snacks or something healthy, shit like that. You should have a designated person on the bus on behalf of everyone that's on the bus, letting production know what it is you need. Production doesn't need to be hearing from every person individually. That'll drive them crazy. There's 100 people on the tour. Just find one person on your bus that's willing to take the responsibility and be the liaison between everyone on the bus and the production. Last but not least, tip your bus driver. So if you've been touring as much as I have, you've experienced many, many different bus drivers. Some are amazing, some are crap. When you have a good bus driver, you know it. You sleep through the night, the drive is super, super smooth, things aren't falling, just great stuff. If you're lucky enough to have one of those drivers, tip them well. Have someone collect money from everyone that's on the bus, could be you, and give it to your driver. I'm sure they'd appreciate it. So if there's anything else you want to know or you have any questions about, just leave it in your comments after you smash the like button. And I'll get back to you. See you soon.